So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. And as you all know that this is the last day of this year 2021, so it is the time that you should give some time to yourself ki ye saal aapka kaisa beeta. Agar acha beeta to very good, agar nahi beeta so it is the time. गिव सम टाइम टू योर सेल्फ कि एनालाइज करो कि इस साल में जो जो प्रॉब्लम्स आई या जो जो चीज़ें सही तरीके से नहीं हुई उनको मैं कैसे सही कर सकता हूँ या कर सकती हूँ. एंड विश योर सेल्फ अ हैप्पी न्यू यू, नॉट हैप्पी न्यू ईयर. न्यू ईयर तो हर साल आएगा बट अपना एक एडवांस वर्जन लाना बहुत ज़्यादा जरूरी है. ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप. हियर यू विल गेट द PDF ऑफ दिस सेशन. And you can ask any doubt here. The link is provided in the description. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with respect to Atal ranking of institutions on innovation achievements. And you have to identify the incorrect statement here. Incorrect statement identify karni hai with respect to this ranking of institutions on innovation achievements. So Ministry of Education has released the Atal ranking of institutions on innovation achievements, and this ranking ranks the higher educational institutions. First of all, this is not for the schools, this is only for the higher educational institutions and universities in India on indicators related to promotion and support of innovation and entrepreneurship development. इनोवेशन एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट के लिए ये हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस और यूनिवर्सिटीज किस तरीके से काम कर रही हैं, किस तरीके से ये लोग इनोवेशन को प्रमोट कर रहे हैं और सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं, इसके बेसिस पे दिस रैंकिंग प्रोवाइड रैंकिंग्स टू द हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस एंड यूनिवर्सिटीज. ऑलराइट, इट्स फर्स्ट एडिशन रिमेंबर वाज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 2019 एंड दिस इज द थर्ड एडिशन इन विच टोटल 1438 institutions participated. Do you remember this number also? 1438 institutions ne isme participate kiya. And as I told you already that it is an initiative of Ministry of Education implemented through AICTE, All India Council of Technical Education, and Ministry of Education's Innovation Cell. Ministry of Education ka Innovation Cell hai aur AICTE, in dono ke through isko implement kiya gaya hai. Alright. And remember, the institutes are categorized into two parts, technical and non-technical. And further, the technical institutes are sub-categorized into five groups. जो technical है उनकी पांच sub-categories भी हैं. Number one is the centrally funded technical institutes, central universities and institute of national importance. This is number one. Number two is state university and deemed university. Number three, government, college or institutions. Number four, universities and deemed universities. And number five, private colleges or institutions. Okay, so these are the five subcategories. These are the five subcategories of technical institutes. All right. Now let's talk about the ranking then. So in the technical category, agar hum technical category mein baat kare, so among all the CFTI, central universities and INI, which is Institute of National Importance, IIT Madras has been ranked number one. IIT Madras. Among all the state universities and deemed universities which participated in this ranking, Punjab University from Chandigarh is number one. Among all the government college or institution, it is College of Engineering Pune which is at number one. Then universities and deemed universities mein Kalinga Institute of Industrial Technology which is located in Odisha has been ranked number one. And finally, among all the private colleges or institute, it is GH Raizoni College of Engineering which is located in Maharashtra. And talking about the non-technical category, so in the non-technical category, among all the CFIs, centrally funded institutions, central universities and institute of national importance, Indira Gandhi National Open University Delhi, IGNU jisko bolte hain short mein, has been ranked number one. And among the general institutes, it is Entrepreneurship Development Institute of India which is located in Gujarat has been placed at rank number one. Okay, सो इस रैंकिंग में इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. देन यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. सो इट्स फर्स्ट एडिशन वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2020. यस, दिस इज इनकरेक्ट बिकॉज इट्स फर्स्ट एडिशन वाज launched in the year 2019, and this is the third edition. IGNOU Delhi is ranked number 1 in the non-technical category. This is absolutely correct. Among technical institutes in the category of CFTIs, Central Universities and INI, IIT Bombay has been ranked number 1. No, that's not IIT Bombay, that's IIT Madras. IIT Madras is number 1. So third is also incorrect. 1 and 3 should be the correct answer. Option C, only 1 and 3. Now moving ahead to question number 2. Name the compendium of innovations focused on agriculture featuring 70 startups supported by Atal Incubation Centers of AIM. AIM stands for what? Atal Innovation Mission. Launched by Niti Aayog. ठीक है, कंपेंडियम लॉन्च किया है नीति आयोग ने जिसमें 70 एग्री स्टार्टअप्स का के बारे में डिटेल्स गिवन है. उसी कंपेंडियम का, उसी कंपाइलेशन का, उसी बुक का आपको नाम बताना है. सो रिमेंबर, नीति आयोग हैज रिलीज्ड टू कंपेंडियम्स. वन इज इनोवेशन फॉर यू एंड अनदर इज इंजीनियस टिंकरर्स. इनोवेशन फॉर यू इज अ कंपेंडियम ऑफ इनोवेशन इन द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर featuring 70 startups supported by Atal Innovation Mission. And the Ingenious Tinkerers, it is again a compendium or a book or a compilation of innovation, of innovation on technology featuring 41 innovations from Atal Tinkering Labs across the country. ठीक है, तो दोनों ही compendium है. एक के अंदर एग्रीकल्चर स्टार्टअप्स के बारे में डिटेल्स है, दूसरे के अंदर भी जो 41 न्यू इनोवेशन है with respect to the new and emerging technologies, unke bare mein details hai. Okay, but the question is regarding the agriculture one, so therefore the correct answer will be what? Option A, innovations for you, because that is the compendium which deals with the 70 startups which features not deals with which features 70 startups in from the agriculture sector, and all these startups are supported by the Atal Innovation Mission. Moving ahead to question number 3. Consider the following statements with respect to Gram Ujala Yojana, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now, is this a new scheme? क्या ये कोई newly launched scheme है? नहीं, ये पुरानी scheme है, but we are discussing about this because very recently Convergence Energy Services Limited CESL, which is a subsidiary of Energy Efficiency Services Limited. Energy Efficiency Services Limited का ये subsidiary है. So this CESL has achieved a milestone of distributing 50 lakh LED bulbs under its project Karor of Gram Ujala Yojana. ठीक है, तो एक नया milestone reach हुआ है under the Gram Ujala Yojana. That's why we are discussing it. And what is that milestone? The Convergence Energy Services Limited has distributed 50 lakh LED bulbs under the project Karor of Gram Ujala Yojana. Now talking about Gram Ujala Yojana, so it was launched by the Ministry of Power, which is currently headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. R.K. Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is Ara in Bihar. ठीक है, so this was launched by Ministry of Power for distribution of LED bulbs at a highly subsidized rate. And what is that rate, by the way? Rupees 10 per LED bulb. केवल 10 रुपए per LED bulb के हिसाब से इसमें LED bulb दिया जाता है. And the LED bulbs belong to 7 watt category and 12 watts category. And a guarantee is also provided for 3 years. मतलब 3 साल में अगर खराब हो जाता है तो वो replace कर देते हैं. Now remember, the scheme is being implemented in 5 states, and in 5 states maybe only in the rural areas. This scheme is only for the rural areas, remember this, not for the urban areas. And which are these 5 states? Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Karnataka. Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Karnataka are the 5 states jahan ke rural areas mein this scheme is being implemented. Okay, so let's come back to the question now. You have to identify the correct statement. Under the scheme, LED bulbs are provided at a highly subsidized rate of rupees 15 per bulb. नहीं, 15 नहीं है, it is rupees 10. It is being implemented in 5 states, Bihar, UP, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Haryana. नहीं, Haryana नहीं है, the fifth one is Karnataka. Fifth one is Karnataka, so this statement is also incorrect. Under the scheme, CESL achieved a milestone of distributing 1 crore LED bulbs. 1 crore नहीं है भाई, 50 लाख है. So all the statements are incorrect here, but we have to identify the correct statements, which means option D. Option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. Now moving ahead to question number 4, which is the last question for today. In which state Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship has launched, which is headed by Dharmendra Pradhan, who is also the Minister of Education, has launched a project for upskilling the cane and bamboo artisans under recognition of prior learning program of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. So remember, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship has launched a pilot project. Remember, this is a pilot project for upskilling of cane and bamboo artisans in the state of Nagaland. कहाँ के लिए? नागालैंड के लिए. एंड जैसा कि क्वेश्चन में भी मेंशन था दैट दिस प्रोजेक्ट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड अंडर द रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ प्रायर लर्निंग प्रोग्राम ऑफ प्रधानमंत्री कौशल विकास योजना एंड द टारगेट इज टू अपस्किल टोटल 4000 आर्टिसंस अंडर दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोजेक्ट. टोटल 4000 आर्टिसंस और क्राफ्ट्समैन को इसमें ट्रेनिंग दी जाएगी, अपस्किलिंग किया जाएगा उनका. एंड दीज आर्टिसंस एंड वीवर्स विल बी अलाइंड विद द नेशनल स्किल्स क्वालिफिकेशन फ्रेमवर्क एंड which agency will monitor this project? It is Handicrafts and Carpet Sector Skill Council, which works under the Ministry of, which works under, in fact, the National Skill Development Corporation (NSDC), and this works, of course, under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So, Handicrafts and Carpet Sector Skill Council will have the responsibility to monitor this project. All right. So therefore, guys, the correct answer will be what? Nagaland, because this pilot project has been launched by the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship in Nagaland. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you on the Monday in the next session and in the next year, 2022. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.